Please don't cancel us, thank you. So a few days back, something just really hit me in my mind that made me think that PTA is just not in the best state that it used to be in. Like, it's different, but not in a good way. So I asked a few people how they thought about it, like Tommy Tabby and all that, and let me tell you, Tommy Tabby wrote a dire essay, which could make up for a very good video script, you know, but I'll paraphrase this, you know, if you want to read the whole thing, you can, but whatever. A few other members of the community also brought out their points on how they feel about the current state of PTA, which is nice, so yeah, let's get into it. Well, okay, I'm kind of exaggerating with this part, but still, PTA does make some really useless decisions. Now, I get it. The R62s do not run on the Lexington Avenue lines anymore in real life. But why would you cut it from Newport? Like, come on, some people want that train in there. Now, I'm not really gonna dump on Potato for doing this, but if we have Game Pass trains like the R27 in Callahan, why can't we run it in Fifth Avenue, you know? Like, we paid for those trains, even though it's like cents, but whatever. Still, can we at least run those in the R179 to 5th Avenue and Callahan? Like, they should be usable in all B Division games. Now, even though surfing is not a bannable offense anymore, it still is strongly discouraged and has gotten some people banned long before in the past. Taking a quote from Gordon and Thomas and friends,
"It isn't wrong, but we just don't do it."
Now, one thing that I am gonna complain about is preventing people from surfing, like anti-surf scripts, and that is something that Tommy Tabby, in his statement, seems as a problem. In the past, I really was an anti-surf person, but now, I can see why some people would be kinda mad about it. Now, there was a lot of incidents of people being underage in the PTA Discord server, and my god, some of them are actually crazy, but hey, that's a topic for a different time. While I can't confirm this to be true, and I don't want to be accused of saying it's true, maybe there's a little bit of nepotism going on in here, you know? Some people can get away with the rules, some people, others cannot. So, that's a thing. I could keep going on and on about rules and regulations and restrictions, but that may get me canceled, so we'll just move on. Okay, this one may cause a firestorm too, but I'm sorry. The community is really just not good. This doesn't go for everyone since I've met a lot of good people in the PTA community, but it's just not perfect, let's just say that. Now there's a lot of different type of people in the PTA community, such as the admin foamers, the regular foamers, which are good people, and the people who are like to just, you know, do bad things and just be annoying. Because of these types of people, this is kinda, I think, making some people like wanna drive away from PTA, you know? And that's probably why some admins and PTA staff are probably quitting. Or at least it's part of the reason, I think. Okay, there's something I forgot to put in the rules and regulations section, but there's apparently a new rule where you could get muted for asking for an admin run. Now, this wouldn't be a problem if many of the kids actually knew that, and most of the rules for PTA are listed in the Discord server. And my god, it makes for a good grocery list, really. And most of the kids do not know many of the rules, so of course, they'll get banned, or muted, or whatever. So, maybe list out the rules better? Not a criticism, just a little recommendation. Tommy Tabby also mentioned this point, which I'm gonna read out loud. "I also somewhat feel as if PTA is getting a bit too realistic. The punch boxes in Newport are a decent example of this. New, underage, experienced players may not know how to operate them without someone directly telling them how they work, and even they might not understand it. I feel as if PTA should be realistic visually while also being somewhat simple to drive/operate in." The whole being too realistic thing is, well, okay, I got some opinions on this. For one, I'm up for realism. Sure, make the game realistic if you want to. That's great, it's awesome. But at the same time, could you also like add a simple mode for like, you know, mobile players or simple players like me? I don't really got too much to comment on this, but I think it is kind of becoming a problem, at least a bit. Oh, and the whole thing about fleet assignments? Yeah, that's getting a little controversial now. I have a problem with that. One interesting point that Tommy Tabby did bring up, which I sort of agree with, but also don't agree with. He said, I feel like most train rebuilds are completely pointless, such as the PST5R and PST3R. I prefer the older versions of those, and even if they were on the old drive system, I don't think it was time to replace them since most of them still looked very modern or something that was built recently. Now, while most people may agree with this claim, thing is, I really kinda don't. This was mainly because the versions of those trains were kinda looking old, okay? Okay, they didn't look old, but the PST3R, the old version, was really, really oversized and big. And you just can't scale a train down that easily, so that one had to be replaced. And for the case of the PST4R, that train could just use a refresh. Not an entire strip down, destroy and rebuild kind of thing. Now I admit, some trains may need a rebuild, like the R40s, but you know what, I wish those models could be free models after they were built, you know? You know what, that just gave me a video idea. You know, I'll talk about like that later. Anyway, that's all I gotta say for this part. Not really much. In conclusion, what are my thoughts on this? Well, I don't think PTA is really dying, per se. But, like, I think it's heading in the not-so-good to, like, kind of mid-section, if you know what I mean. Before the video ends, I'm gonna leave you off a few quotes from some people.
Newport hype.
PTA is great. The community is great. But there's some stuff that's gotta change. Things such as the community that's toxic and eating away at the core ever so slowly, bit by bit. I have honestly seen increased activity in all the games, and with Newport on the horizon. I'm saying that the future for PTA is looking good, so a bright future.